Hi guys. So recently I did a video where I discussed some books that I probably, based off of my personal tastes, shouldn't really like, but have ended up loving. And now I'm going to be doing the opposite of that. I'm going to be going over some books that I should love based off of my tastes, but don't. Jumping right into it, the first book on this list would be The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang. I didn't hate this book. It's not like I hate it with a burning passion or anything like that. It's just that I ended up not absolutely loving it. And my personal taste, generally, I love to follow characters. I love when the characters are what propel the plot forward. I love when characters are faced with the reality of the world that they were not expecting. I always think that's a fantastic, I guess it's a trope in stories where they think they got everything figured out and all of a sudden the world just kind of hits them in the face with its horribleness. That's a terrible thing to like in stories, but I do. And I also love an underdog story. And in The Poppy War, we follow a Chinese-inspired society. It's very heavily rooted in Chinese history. And we have a character where there's a lot of colorism that plays a role in their society. She is of a darker skin color and they look down upon her. She's just seen kind of as this useless peasant, but then she has the opportunity to elevate her status through the military, and I loved that premise, and I was very engrossed in the beginning of the story. If you've read the story, you know there's a little bit of a shift partway through the book where it has that trope where the character gets kind of hit in the face with the crazy stuff, and I loved that moment. There were so many things about the story that I loved. However, I also found Rin, I liked her initially. I liked her drive. I liked the fact that she was pretty morally gray at times, but I still ultimately was so invested in her story that I wanted to keep reading. I wanted to see what was gonna happen next. I wanted to know if she was gonna be okay. I never felt like anyone that she was around was safe, and I loved that feeling. But toward the end of the story, Rin just started to kind of drive me crazy. Also, I definitely felt like there were times where, for example, the character in her training, she has to run up this mountain with a little piglet on her back, and then she has to keep doing this continuously as the pig grows up into a giant, massive, full-grown pig. And our character is really, really small, and I don't know, at some point I was kind of like, I don't really feel like she'd be able to do that. And then there were also instances where in her training, she is going up against people who have had training their whole life, and she kind of is able to kind of get as good as them by just knowing a different technique. And that's not, I don't really like that trope of like, well, I have my footing slightly different, so now I'm able to keep up with these kids who have been able to fight their whole lives. It kind of ends up making it feel like the underdog part of it is maybe less so because they're able to just match other people kinda easily. It's still, I would say, a fantastic story. I absolutely want to see what else this author does. I can't wait to see what else they write, but ultimately Rin, it really came down to her. She just kind of started to drive me crazy. Next up, we have a comic by Tom King, and that would be Vision. This is one of my husband's favorite comics, and I picked it up, and I definitely understand why it's so incredibly moving. I love stories that just kind of sit and examine what feels like what should be basic, but it actually has a lot of depth. And I feel like that's what that story does. It's in some ways pretty obvious and in other ways really nuanced. And its examination of family and how some are seen as lesser and things like that, I really loved those elements. But I do feel like while a lot of people feel you don't have to be super knowledgeable of the Marvel Universe, you don't need to know a lot going into Vision, you can just read that and then you're good. I don't feel that necessarily. I do think it helps to have more context, and I am not that familiar. I have no problem admitting that I'm not that familiar with the Marvel Universe outside of the movies, and even then I haven't even seen all of the ones in the Marvel Universe. I just feel like my knowledge of the characters isn't deep enough to really appreciate everything that's going on in that story. Next up would be City of Brass by S.A. Chakraborty, and this is a story where it took me super long, a really long time, to get into it, and then by the end I was like, man, I can't wait for the sequel because I really liked the ending. It had so much political intrigue. I really loved that the inspiration for the story was quite different from a lot of other fantasy books because you're following a character who is living, it's kind of like historical fiction initially, in Egypt, the character, but then she kind of gets involved in this world with djinn and this city, this magical city, and all of that is so cool, right up my alley. I loved all those things about it. I really loved the political intrigue. However, I think this is one of those stories where either the characters just didn't really click with me, their relationships weren't really in relationships I felt that invested in, or I need a reread. There's actually a lot to the politics of their world, and there's a lot of nuances with why this group hates this group, and why this group wants to ally with this group, but also feels like they can't because of this over here. There's a lot of little intricate things going on that are actually pretty complex, and I love that, but I just feel like some of it went over my head a little bit, so maybe I just need to reread that and give it another try. I would be very open to eventually giving it another try someday. However, there's no guarantee that if I tried it again, I would love it. This is partially, I would say, because one of the other things that I didn't love about it was the main character sometimes, you're gonna see a theme here. A lot of times the main characters frustrate me, but the main character sometimes, I just felt like I didn't understand why she felt the way she felt in certain situations or towards certain people. And it annoyed me a lot. I'm like, why do you, like, certain characters who aren't that nice to her, and she kind of has the hots for them, and I'm like, why? Is it even hate to love? It's more like this person, this relationship has not got a lot of development, but the person's hot, so we're attracted to them, kind of sort of a setup, except for it's not quite overtaking the story. It would just happen here and there, and that would kind of make me confused toward that character. Like, I didn't understand why she would feel that way. But like I said, maybe if I just reread it, I would feel differently. Next up, we have Alchemists of Loom. And this is a story I read quite a while ago. It's kind of a steampunk type fantasy. There's chimera, there's alchemy. And I thought so much of it was very interesting. I kind of was rooting for the characters. I didn't feel that invested with them, and I don't always need to feel that invested with the characters. It's just that I did like them somewhat. I didn't love them, but the thing that I think made it so that I should have loved the story was it felt very video game-esque, and I love video games, but I think that's also a double-edged sword because there were so many instances in this book where I just felt like it would have been cooler as a video game. It was almost like so unique that in book form I just wanted to see everything, and I wanted to see this somewhat steampunk mechanical-esque type world. I wanted to visualize it. I didn't want to visualize it. I just wanted to see it in front of me. So I actually feel like that one should just be made into a video game. I think it would be fantastic. There are definitely a lot more books that I can mention, but I'm going to just have one more on this list, and that would be All the Light We Cannot See. This one, I feel like, so suits my quote-unquote grown-up tastes, meaning I don't know that I would have thought I'd have loved this when I was younger, but where I currently am in my reading tastes, this should have absolutely been right up my alley. This is a historical fiction story. It's dual perspective, and it's also split timeline. You follow one character who is blind and has been displaced from her home. She's had to leave her home because of World War II going on. And then the other character is a young German boy who's been recruited into the military. And it's one of those stories where it's so well illustrates how some people just have no control over their lives, and it takes so much time to develop these characters because you do follow them over a decently large period of their lives, their youth, I should say. And I really loved so much about it. I thought it was so powerful and so moving, but I've mentioned before that there is a very obvious symbolism element going on with the story, with this diamond. And while I'm not totally opposed to magical realism, I'm not totally opposed to symbolism in stories. Obviously, I mean, everything has symbolism pretty much to an extent. I just really did not care for the way it was executed in this story. It made it so bizarre because I was going in thinking this was going to just be this very deep emotional historical fiction book, and then it'd be like, this diamond is all the, are all these terrible things happening because of this diamond? And I'm like, no, clearly not. It's clearly not because of the diamond. But then it's just, I just was not expecting that element. And I have discovered since reading The Kingdom of Bag that I do really love magical realism. Maybe I'm just too stupid for that book. You know, that could be too. I just feel like I didn't like the diamond stuff. Anyway, that's a list of some books that, based off of my personal taste, I definitely feel I probably should have loved these books. I expected to love them, but ultimately, I just didn't. I do have reviews for almost all of these, so I'll have those linked down below if you want a little bit more in-depth thoughts. Let me know which books were this for you. But anyway, thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.